Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to talk about the matrix representations of sine graphs and also orientations of sine graphs. To recap, a sine graph is basically a graph where the edges have a positive or negative sign. The adjacency matrix of a sine graph is similar to the adjacency matrix of your typical graph. If our sine graph has n vertices numbered from 1 to n, then our adjacency matrix is an n by n matrix where a given row or column corresponds to a vertex, and the entry ij in the matrix is 1 if vertex I is adjacent to vertex j through a positive edge, or negative 1 if vertex I is adjacent to vertex j through a negative edge. The entry ij is 0 when the vertices I and j are not adjacent. If our graph happens to be a multigraph with multiple edges between some pair of vertices I and j, the corresponding entry ij in the adjacency matrix is a number of positive edges between vertices I and j minus the number of negative edges between I and j. Let's look at two examples. First, let's find the adjacency matrix of this sine graph. No vertex is adjacent to itself in this graph, so the diagonal entries will be 0. Vertex 1 is adjacent to vertices 2 and 3 with a positive edge, and to vertex 4 with a negative edge, so entry 1, 2, and 1, 3 will be positive 1, and entry 1, 4 will be negative 1. Vertex 2 is adjacent to vertices 1 and 3 with positive edges, and adjacent to vertex 4 with a negative edge. So entries 2, 1, and 2, 3 are positive 1, and entry 2, 4 is negative 1. Vertex 3 is adjacent to vertices 1 and 2 with positive edges, and adjacent to vertex 4 with a negative edge. So entries 3, 1, and 3, 2 are positive 1, and entry 3, 4 is negative 1. Finally, vertex 4 is adjacent to vertices 1, 2, and 3 with negative edges. So entries 4, 1, 4, 2, and 4, 3 are all negative 1. This is our adjacency matrix. For our second example, let's do a signed multigraph. We'll need to subtract the number of negative edges from the number of positive edges linking a pair of vertices in order to find out what value we put and their corresponding entry in the adjacency matrix. I encourage you to pause the video and find the adjacency matrix of this graph yourself. Here it is. Now, before we check out incidence matrices of sine graphs, we'll need to define orientations of sine graphs. Orienting a sine graph means to give a direction to each end of every edge in a graph. However, there are some rules that we have to follow when we orient sine graphs that are not in place when we orient an unsigned graph. If an edge is positive, the direction we assign to both ends of that edge must be the same. If an edge is negative, the direction we assign to both ends of that edge must be opposite. When the two ends of an edge point in the same direction, as with oriented positive edges in a sine graph, we call that edge directed. And when they point inwards in opposite directions, we call that edge introverted. And when they point outwards in opposite directions, we call that edge extraverted. These are the orientations that we're allowed to assign to positive or negative edges in a sine graph. Positive edges always directed, and negative edges always introverted or extroverted. As a little side note, an unsigned graph with extroverted, introverted, and directed edges is called a bidirected graph. And with the rules we just established, we can say that each bidirected graph has a unique underlying sine graph, obtained by assigning a negative sign to each edge that is either introverted or extroverted, and assigning a positive sign to each edge that is directed. This is interesting because it lets us apply the theory of sine graphs to bidirected graphs. All right, back to sine graphs. Now that we have these orientation rules in place, let's look at the incidence matrix of a sine graph. To find the incidence matrix, first, orient the graph in any permissible way. Then, generate a matrix where the rows correspond to vertices in our sine graph and the columns correspond to edges in our sine graph. The entry ij in our matrix is positive 1 if edge j is oriented into vertex I. The entry ij is negative 1 if edge j is oriented out of vertex I. Finally, the entry ij is 0 if edge j is not incident to vertex I. In a sine graph, edges are always incident to exactly two vertices, so there are only two non-zero entries per column of our matrix. And if a column represents a positive edge, the sum of the entries in the column is 0. And if a column represents a negative edge, the sum of the entries in that column is either 2 or negative 2. Think back to the possible orientations of positive and negative edges to see why this is the case. Now that we have defined incidence matrices, you might be wondering why are we talking about the incidence matrix of a graph? Because it seems like changing the orientation would give rise to a different incidence matrix. And while that is true, changing the orientation does change the incidence matrix. All of the incidence matrices we get through different orientations of the same sine graph can be related to each other by negating some subset of each column in the incidence matrix. In other words, the incidence matrix of a sine graph is unique up to negation of subsets of columns. This is because when we change the orientation of an edge, the result in the incidence matrix is simply a negation of the entries in that edge's column. For example, looking at edge 1, when we changed its orientation, it went from leading into vertex 1 and into vertex 2, meaning the entries 1, 1, and 2, 1 were positive, to leading out of vertex 1 and out of vertex 2, making the entries 1, 1, and 2, 1 negative. That's all for this video. In my next video, we'll take a look at sine graph colorings. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment if you liked the video. Have a great day.